With the release of Byleth, there is now 82 characters in Smash Ultimate. That number is not only far more than any other Smash game, but greater than most fighting games in general. Although it can already be mind-boggling to think of every character, now consider that each has over 15 different moves, resulting in over 1,000 moves in the game. If you play Smash often, you might actually know what every single move is, and if so, give yourself a pat on the back, because you're a dedicated Smasher. Whether you know every move or not, there are definitely some moves that everyone knows because they're just so good, and you see them all the time. In this video, we'll be listing the top 15, yes, 15, we couldn't just pick 10 for this one, best moves in Smash Ultimate, and going into just what makes them so great. For more info on any character's moveset, check out the resources on our website, proguides.com. We've got character guides, tier lists, as well as exclusive features such as our Play with Pros platform that connects you with coaches instantly, and our pro courses that give you a chance to learn from top players like MKLeo. Politania's Nair manages to find its way into so many of our videos, much like how it finds its way into so many top 8s. Well, it's for good reason. Politania's Nair has amazing utility and is easily one of the best moves in the game. This move combos into itself at low percents for a quick 40 damage, and also is amazing for anti-airing, retreating out of shield, ledge trapping, and edge guarding. Falco's up tilt is a vital part of his neutral and playstyle in general. This move's ability to start combos makes it his first goal in so many situations, as it can combo into itself into any aerial. Eventually leading to KO confirms with back air, Falco's up tilt is also an outstanding anti-air tool, easily beating jump-in approaches and catching landings. This doesn't mean it isn't good on the ground also, as it hits low enough to punish grounded opponents and is tricky to punish on shield when spaced well. Falco would probably drop a whole tier if he lost his up tilt. Like Politania, Wario has many amazing tools in his moveset, but as with Politania's Nair, there's one Wario move you never want to get hit by. That's right, we're talking about the waft. When Wario flaunts his fabulous, fantastic flatulence, you don't want to be on the receiving end. This move is one of the strongest KO moves in the game, especially considering how fast it comes out. Waft also deals tons of damage, and there are so many ways to combo into it, so it's no wonder they made this move take almost 2 minutes to fully charge. Although the half-charged waft is still really strong. When it comes to camping, Young Link does it better than most, and arguably, the biggest reason for this is his amazing Fire Arrow. Fire Arrow fires very fast and covers a large horizontal distance in a short amount of time, interrupting any grounded approach. The arrow shot has reasonably low end lag too, so Young Link can react accordingly to changing situations. Fire Arrow isn't just a great zoning and camping tool, it also has excellent combo potential at almost any percent, linking it to itself, aerials, and even up B for KO confirms at higher percents. This move is easily one of the best projectiles in Smash Ultimate. Many of these moves on the list come from DLC characters, and it's clear that the developers probably aim for these as potential selling points too. Banjo and Kazooie have one classic DLC move with their Wonder Wing. Wonder Wing is a forward charge that has invincibility, tons of knockback, and deals a lot of damage. Thanks to the invincibility, Banjo can safely challenge any attack with Wonder Wing and potentially take stocks at mid percents off of one callout. This move can even be comboed into from Banjo's grenade, which is a big part of his gameplay. Since Wonder Wing travels a good distance horizontally, it's also a great recovery move that can't be edgeguarded easily. With all these applications, it's understandable why this move is limited to 5 uses per stock. Oh hey, it's this guy again. Mr. Game & Watch was chosen as our best edgeguarder in Smash Ultimate, and one of the main reasons was his back air. This disjointed multi-hit aerial has lots of range behind Game & Watch, making it super easy and consistent to wall out offstage opponents. The move also has decent knockback, making it a safe KO option at ledge, and isn't bad in neutral either. The range and multi-hits make Game & Watch's back air a safe move to pressure shields with, and it can catch jumps as well. Zelda's Phantom Knight is one of the most notorious moves on quick play, and it's an amazing tool offline as well. Because Zelda can move while charging the Phantom after some time, she gains incredible option coverage in many scenarios. In neutral, many players will try to jump over the Phantom only to get up-aired by Zelda, and if they shield the Phantom, Zelda can grab them. The Phantom also lunges a huge distance when fully charged, and a slash hits high enough to catch jumps and low enough to hit ledge. This move is fairly flexible as Zelda can control the timing of the attack during startup, so it's an effective zoning tool at any distance outside of close range. Wolf is an amazing fundamental character, with his moveset greatly rewarding Smash basics. His neutral air is a multi-purpose tool that's a great option in many situations. It's quick enough to use as an out-of-shield punish or retreat with to escape close quarters. In neutral, Nair is a great anti-air and spacing tool, as its long active frames and low end lag make it easy to hit with and difficult to punish. It leads to so many combos as well, comboing into grab at early percents and dash attack at higher percents. Nair also sets up for tech chases that can net Wolf early KOs with his deadly down smash. Last but not least, Wolf's Nair is a phenomenal edge trapping move, easily covering multiple options at once. Bringing it back to the DLC, Joker's moveset becomes immensely buffed when he activates Arsene. With Arsene, his back air lets him apply dominating pressure thanks to its increased range, knockback, and already great frame data. In neutral, Joker can outspace most characters with Arsene Bear and cover high and low options with the ability to throw out two bears in a full hop. Once the opponent is off stage, it will usually take no more than two back airs to KO or gimp any character, making this one of the best edgeguarding tools in the game. Back air can also be comboed into at low percents from a grab and at higher percents from down air and the first hit of fair for a KO confirm. Roy and Crom tend to wind up fighting up close as their fast ground speed and unruly air control make microspacing difficult, but they have one move in particular that makes up close pressure a cinch. Jab. Roy and Crom's jab is an amazing shield pressure tool that's very safe when done anywhere outside of point blank range. Since Smash Ultimate allows jabs to be performed quickly out of a dash, this move can be a very effective whiff punish option as well, especially with what it leads into. Jab can combo into aerials at many percents, most notably leading to KO confirms with back air and a large percent window. The large range of this move also makes it capable of trapping landings and covering many ledge options, even sometimes hitting ledge hangs. Ivysaur's down air is a gigantic spike that hits far into the ledge to easily edgeguard many recoveries without going off stage. So it just goes to show you how good his up air is, because that's the move we actually want to talk about. Ivy's up air, like his dare, is quite massive. And it's also an amazing KO move. At early percents, up air can combo out of a down throw and link into another up air to rack up damage quickly. He can also use Razor Leaf to set up for up airs at KO percent. The sheer size and power of his up air naturally conditions opponents to land differently and with far more fear, as it's such a huge threat above him. We mentioned how Falco's up tilt was an amazing combo tool, while Snake's up tilt, on the other hand, is an amazing KO option. If you're above Snake over 100%, you can't land anywhere near him. Up tilt has a huge hitbox that also hits quite far in front of him, so at high percents, this move makes approaching Snake very scary. Up tilt is a great anti-air at any percent, sometimes even linking into itself for lots of damage. At 160 or higher, Snake can true combo his up tilt out of a down throw for a guaranteed KO. Terry Bogard is known for his flashy moves like Busta Wolf and Power Dunk, but most of his flashy specials share a common starter, his jab. Terry's jab comes out on frame 3 and can be canceled to combo into almost any of his special moves. This gives him a super quick whiff punish option that builds up tons of damage and sets up for KOs at higher percents. Jab can also be canceled into crack shoot to make it safe on shield, so he can approach with jab with little worry of being punished. His jab pressure tends to condition players into shield as well, making grabs easier to find. Joker with Arsene has too many good moves to only list one. With Arsene, Joker's side B is Aegon, a fast downward arcing projectile that creates an explosion on contact with the stage or characters, and it deals 20 damage over time. The amount of damage done by such a fast long-range projectile lets Joker apply ample pressure to opponents who are very likely to run away and camp during Arsene's active period. This move also gives Joker a safe way to pressure offstage opponents above ledge and can even KO from this position. And when Joker is offstage himself, it's a great way to ward off edgeguarders. Terry also makes this list twice, thanks to Power Geyser! Terry's Power Geyser is one of his super specials unlocked at 100% or higher. This move shoots a humongous energy blast in front of and above Terry. Power Geyser does tons of damage and KOs fairly early too, but its range is what makes this move so good. If you're attempting to jump in against Terry, this move can anti-air as high as the top platform of Battlefield, and almost a roll distance away from Terry horizontally. Power Geyser is great for ledge trapping thanks to this range, and he can even combo into it from up tilt at almost any percent. So this one is kinda like cheating, but we're gonna finish off this list with Hero's Command Selection. Command Selection encompasses so many amazing attacks and almost any of them could have made this list. So we figure it makes more sense just to include the move as a whole. Hero can do so many broken things with Command Selection. He can buff his attributes with moves like Oomph and Accelerate. He can fire lightning fast projectiles that KO like Sizzle and Kaboom. He can cheese you with moves like Thwack and Magic Burst. And he can even access abilities otherwise reserved for items like Invisibility and Turning Giant with Hocus Pocus. Naturally, these wild abilities would come with the DLC character. As an honorable mention, we didn't want to omit Olimar's up smash. It's a powerful smash attack that combos into itself and his aerials, and it's pretty safe on shield. But it was so much better before being nerfed, so it didn't quite make this list in its current state. As for which move we think is best in the game, we're going with Palutena's Nair. Although there's plenty of counterplay to deal with this move, Palu's Nair is extremely versatile and can be a good, if not great, option in so many situations. If you're stranded on a deserted island and you can only use one move, we recommend Palutena's neutral air. What do you think is the best move in Smash Ultimate? Let us know in the comments and be sure to subscribe to ProGuides and click that bell to keep up with our future uploads.